A ball of mass m and velocity v contacts a hard surface at a 45-degree angle and bounces off the surface also at a 45-degree angle and at speed v, as shown in situation 1. Also shown is the force vector F, representing the force exerted by the surface on the ball. Situation 2 shows the same ball moving with the same velocity and contacts a soft surface. The time of contact is greater with the soft surface than the hard surface. The ball bounces off the soft surface at an angle of 30 degrees and with speed v2 less than v. Which of the following vectors could represent the force exerted on the ball in situation 2? The force is the quotient impulse divided by time interval. Therefore, the direction of the force vector should be the same as the direction of the impulse vector. However, it is a direct consequence of Newton's second law that impulse is the change in momentum delta p. Therefore, the direction of the force is actually given by the direction of delta p. But delta p is equal to the product of mass times delta v, the change in velocity. Since the mass is a scalar, the direction is determined by the vector delta v. Remember, the final velocity is smaller in magnitude and has a smaller angle with the x-axis. Therefore, the change in velocity has a direction in the first quadrant, as shown. That direction is also the direction of the change in momentum, the impulse, and the force exerted by the surface. Therefore, the correct answer is option C.